Taoiseach, parents in this country are under pressure. The cost of accommodation is out of control and out of the reach of too many. Childcare bills are rising. There's no sign of any incremental progress on the extension of GP care for children that we were making progress on. The modern workplace puts enormous pressure on parents. They fight to sustain their careers and raise their families. But the budget we just had did little for those parents. No increase in child benefit. Creches raised their prices. No subsidy increase on childcare. Nothing to address, as I say, the ever-rising price of a home. Indeed, they got tax cuts that actually cost them money, because they'll have to pay more for the basic services that the state should be providing, from healthcare to childcare to education. And last week, the ESRI made it official. Didn't go much noticed. Their study on the distributional impact of tax and welfare in the last budget confirmed that it wouldn't even give the price of a cup of coffee. Instead, it would cost people. It shows all income groups, that's shocking, all income groups will suffer losses, with the lowest income groups being hardest hit and the best off losing least. Families with a single earner lose most. In an economy where the cost of everything is increasing, where wages aren't rising fast enough, people will actually be worse off. Now, in a recovering economy, that's some achievement. But there are actions that can be taken that would give parents a break. Parents in Ireland have the right to 18 weeks of unpaid parental leave. And for many, that leave is absolutely necessary for a sick child or other issues, but at a huge cost. The Programme for a Partnership Government says that the government will increase paid parental leave in the first year of birth. In the manifesto for Leader that you produced, you said that you would improve and extend contributory benefits such as parental leave. And you said something similar in your address to the Fine Gael National Conference recently. Yet, the Sunday Times last weekend reported, in a report written by Valerie Flynn, that the government wants to delay the implementation of the new EU law, an EU law that would give Irish workers the right to 4 months of paid parental leave. An Irish official was reported to have said that the Irish government had reservations in relation to these matters. So my question is a very simple one, Taoiseach. Why, on the one hand, is the government saying it wants to give paid parental leave, and on the other, behind closed doors in Brussels, is it saying the opposite? Will the government introduce 4 months of paid parental leave, as is being discussed in the EU directive, and when will it do so?
It's absolutely government policy to introduce paid parental leave. I'm not involved personally in the negotiations in Brussels. But it is government policy that we want to introduce paid parental leave, allowing parents to share the leave among themselves. At the moment, maternity benefit and paternity benefit are separate. We'd like to have a parental leave with parental benefit attached to it, which would allow parents to share it. And we will be obviously guided by the European law in that regard. If the Deputy wants evidence of that, we've increased maternity benefit and paternity benefit twice now. This government of Fine Gael, the Independent Alliance and Independence, we've extended maternity benefit to cover children who are born prematurely, to give their mothers a bit more time with them. And we've introduced paid parental leave, paid paternal leave, and increased it once. So that's what we actually are doing. And yes, it is our plan to move towards a new system of parental leave with parental benefit attached to it, which parents can share between each other. Although realistically, we're talking legislation next year and introduction the year after that. Deputy will know that the ESRI does its analysis in a particular way. He was an enormous critic of it when he was around the Cabinet table. And he will know that the ESRI, when it does its analysis, doesn't take into account the benefit of any service improvements. So if you improve the health service, if you improve education, if you bring in subsidised childcare, that doesn't count for anything using the ESRI switch analysis. And they also use a particular system where they adjust for average increases in wage earnings. What real people will do throughout January is they will look at their payslips. And what people will do throughout January, February, March, they'll look at the amount of money that's coming into their pockets. And what will they find? People who are working will see a reduction in their USE. People on middle incomes will see that the standard rate cut-off point is going to go up, and they'll pay less of their income at the higher rate. People who need medicines will find that their prescription charges go down in January, not just for people with medical cards, but also people who don't have medical cards. People with kids will find that they're getting a second year, a full second year of free preschool. People who are in low pay, like those on the minimum wage, will see the minimum wage go up in January. Public servants will see pay restoration and pay increases happening in two tranches next year, in January and October. People whose children are in receipt of childcare, particularly those with children between 6 months and 3 years, will see the subsidies for childcare continuing throughout the year with targeted benefits for those on low incomes. And as mentioned being earlier, people who are in receipt of carers allowance will see a right of a GP visit card being extended to them. And of course, low-income families, those in receipt of family income supplement, will gain as much as €10 extra a week from March, when those changes come into effect. And also lone parents who are working will have significant gains as well. So that's what people are going to see. And the Deputy can try and denigrate the government achievements all he likes. What we're starting to see now is something that I'm committed to making happen as Taoiseach and as head of this government, is people, all individuals, all families and all parts of the country seeing their living standards improve as the economy does.
I think we're now, Kian Cole, entering a Trump world of alternative facts. The truth is that most people will see some improvement to the value of about a cup of coffee, as I said. But the real cost of providing childcare, of being able to afford a home, is receding from them. But that reality is lost on you. So can I ask you, just in relation to the net question that I've asked, because this notion that, yes, you're in favour of paid parental leave, but we'll have law next year and perhaps achieve parental leave being paid the year after that. 2 years' time, is that your commitment in your programme for government? Or in your manifesto, maybe in 2 years' time? And why is it reported that you are resisting the EU legislation, or is the report authoritatively put in one of the national newspapers false? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, just to be very clear with this, we already have paid parental leave in Ireland, but we do it in a particular way. We have maternity leave and maternity benefit for the mother, and we have paternal leave and paternity benefit for the father. And as a government, we've increased those in the last budget, and we'll increase them again in March, the cash payment, and have also brought in new rules, particularly around premature babies. So that's the system we have at the moment. What we want to do as a government, and what we want to do at a European level as well, is move to a new system of parental leave that would effectively replace maternity leave and paternity leave, and would allow couples the autonomy to choose how they would share that leave and share that benefit among themselves. And at the moment, there is under discussion and under debate a European regulation to bring that into effect. And I'm not party to the detailed negotiation of that, but I can absolutely assure Deputy Howland that the government does intend to support that directive or regulation, bring in parental leave and benefit in Ireland, and change the system we have now to the one that I've outlined. But I do think, first of all, that there should still be a dedicated maternity leave for mothers, because they are the ones who give birth to the baby and they need particular time to recover and other things. So I think we need to have a dedicated carve-out for mothers, and then maybe share the rest, the additional part, between them, the two parents. And in addition to that as well, obviously before we bring in our own legislation, we want to find out what the European legislation is going to be. It wouldn't make any sense at all for us as a government and oireachtas to enact legislation for parental leave here in Ireland in the next few months and then find out that there's a European directive regulation that runs contrary to it 6 months later.